Hey Bolt Hunters, Dead Diggy here with another true Maliwan Takedown fun run video. In my fun run videos, I take non-meta guns and I try to put it up against the raid. The true version or the true variant of fun run videos means I take it into true Maliwan Takedown mode, which is 4-player difficulty. This thing requires full concentration, so there will be no live commentary. I've been failing at this time and time again. I'll go over the build and all that stuff at the end. What you need to know is that this is just a flesh melter build, so I'm going to be trying to leverage the flesh melter bonus stacks and use a corrosive weapon against the raid, which is a real challenge. And the weapon that I'm using primarily is the Breath of the Dying, and the Breath of the Dying's legendary effect is when you kill something, it releases these corrosive orbs that will kill you. So not only are the enemies trying to kill us, but so are our guns. So I'll catch you guys on the next side. Hopefully we'll make it together. Thanks.
Just a cover my arse for a bit.
Thank you.
advanced mechs, but we're off to something bigger. Keep going.
All right, y'all, we're halfway there. That's what I gotta say. See y'all on the other side. Thanks for watching.
Scale for it. dead here. Come on!
Alright y'all, this is it. This is the moment. Man, this has been rather intense. We have it. Excuse me. Sorry about that. Hopefully we have everything we need. Boy, let's do it. I'm excited, I'm nervous. Woo, loud. And alright, I'm gonna shut up now. Wish me luck. It has been a journey. Make sure everything is reloaded. Make sure this is set up. All right, here we go. I'll catch you guys on the other side, hopefully with some success.
Target!
Oh my god. Oh my god, that was intense. This feels, oh shit, this is a motherfucker right here. I forgot about his ass. This feels like, oh shit, almost got myself. Almost murdered myself. Oh man. So that is Flesh Melter, Breath of the Dying, True Maliwan Takedown Fun Run. That was actually a ton of fun. I enjoyed that immensely. It felt a lot like, you know, the first couple weeks of when the Maliwan Takedown was revealed. And we all had sweaty palms as we tried to figure out how to beat this thing. So the dual layer of the enemies trying to kill us and not being down by our own weapons and just keeping all the moving pieces in order has provided a real challenge here. So let's go over everything from the beginning. So first and foremost, these are our weapons, Breath of the Dying. This is our main. This is really how we're leveraging the Flesh Melter, because whenever you kill something with this gun, it releases these corrosive orbs that do massive damage. Hopefully, if you guys were paying attention, you will see some instances where I kill something and then everything around it just disappears. So that's the kind of the crux of the build and what we're trying to do. Then I use the decaying barrage for enemies at range, especially the corrosive heavyweights, because we can't kill them with a corrosive gun because they are, of course, immune. And the trained chaos here, and this is for stripping shields with the bosses, so we used it on the Valkyries and we used it on Wotan, and we also used it on some of the badass war dogs, especially the hack hounds, so we can get those shields stripped quickly because they have massive shields and massive health. And last but not least, and probably most important, is the eruption, because that's how we stack our damage for the boss fights. We didn't really need a lot of stacking for the mobs, but for the Wotan fight, it was very, very useful, as you guys observed. This stopgap, love it, love it, love it. Paired with the quick charge big shot for getting our reset. So the quick charge big shot for everything but the boss fight. We simply cannot risk getting one-shotted. Therefore, we have the stopgap in the boss fight. But we normally use the big shot for the mobs, so we can get those actions, the action skill resets. We talked about this. Everybody knows about the piss, best grenade in the game for the stuff that I like to do. And, you know, a pretty good seeing dead comm. All right. This is my standard Maliwan Takedown raid. Calm, cool, collected build in the green tree, so nothing unique or special here. I didn't go with this because I was thinking about maybe using Elemental Projector if we couldn't do enough damage. Therefore, I wanted to leave that option open, which is why I'd normally leave it open, period. When I do the takedown in the event that I do need to leverage the Elemental Projector. So that's why that's always not chosen. All-rounder, of course, and deterrence field, uber important. You know, sometimes you don't see deterrence field at work, but if you turn the volume up, because, and you can hear it, you can hear when it rejects enemies trying to attack you. So deterrence feel really uber important in this raid, for me at least. At least that's the way I like to play with it. Some changes here in the Hitman tree, then my normal setup. First and foremost, the violent momentum is maxed out. I've been doing the 3-3 split recently, but I've gone 5 points into violent momentum because, as you see, there was a lot of hopping around, a lot of jumping around, a lot of strafing. And that was because I needed to make sure that I avoided getting hit by the orbs. So since I needed to be mobile anyway, I maxed it out to get the extra 20% or more damage. Still using the 3 points for violent speed so we can dodge bullets. Cool hand, 3 points works out really, really well with these Dhal assault rifles because their reload speed is just on balance pretty good. And their reload animation is on balance pretty good too. So 3 points in cool hand is more than enough to not gimp our DPS. 1 point here for our delivery of the piss for the grenade anointment and for the piss to do the magic that the piss does. 4 points because these are burst fire weapons and they're, you know, even though the reloading isn't ridiculous like it was with the EMP5, there is some reloading Therefore, I erred on the side of caution by giving myself more lifesteal instead of less. Normally, what I would do is I'd only use 3 for, you know, high capacity, high damage weapons, and then put the 4 points in cool hands. But for this one, I just needed to be safe and sorry, hence the 4 points in salvation. 1 point in death follows close always for kill skill and duration. Now, here's where things also get interesting. So we got a change up here, we got a change up here, we got a change up here, and now we have change ups here. So this is maxed out because we want to get as many rounds down range, so fire rate is crucially important for our DPS. But we've also spec'd into playing dirty. And we spec'd into playing dirty primarily because, as you can see, this is a single pellet weapon. So every time playing dirty procs, what's the, about 2,600 and change damage. So that's why it was worth going into playing dirty, just to make sure we get that extra damage. And at 90%, 9 times out of 10, we're going to have it procs. And if you go back and you look at the kill skill bar, you'll see that, you know, it's popping up all the time. 1 point for keeping our action skills up during the boss fight. This is another change here. So there's no Winter's Joint. I've gone into Boomsday. 2 reasons. 1, there's no cryo modifier, so we're not getting any benefit. And 2, our artifact is not boosting cryo damage. So since we're not getting any cryo benefit, we're better off going with Boomsday, because Boomsday increases the possibility, or increases the probability, or the frequency that our drone will proc the Seeing Dead comms legendary effect. So because we spent maxed out both these at tier four, we don't have any points left over to spend here. So we spent it here. Now this is a very good trade-off, right? In terms of the amount of damage we would get if we had spent the full points here and on Donnybrook, this beats it. Right, because this just basically doubles our damage versus, you know, 80% from Donnybrook. So, yeah, that's the that's everything. And thank you guys for watching. And I will catch you in the next one. Laters.